Hey everybody, welcome to The Blacklist, the show where we interview the elite. Today we have Yvette right next to me. And for most people that have, they're barely first time on the show, they've probably never seen you before. Who is Yvette and what is it that you do?
Hi everyone, pleasure to be here. Thank you, Ulysses. What I do is I'm a transformational coach.
Okay.
I love to see people smile, transform, and take their life to their next level.
Yeah, and why get into, because you could have chosen any career path, right? Why get into, you know, helping make a transformation in somebody's life?
It's been my passion since I was a young girl. I did my first personal development training with Jose Silva, with the Silva Mind Method at 12 years of age.
Dang, yeah.
And from that point on, I was fascinated with when you control your mind, what's possible and what you're capable of.
Yeah. And do you feel like right now in this day and age, a lot of people are kind of like walking around as zombies and maybe not controlling their mind? They're just kind of like, you know, doing the day to day?
Absolutely. I call it the robotic existence. I call it life in autopilot, where people drive from point A to point B without even noticing.
Right.
There was time, there was traffic or whatever. It's like people do the same things over and over with the same people.
Yeah, yeah.
And there cannot be any changes or any fulfillment, really, when people just do their 9 to 5, the same people, the same things. So I'm here to disrupt that.
Yeah, no, that's good. And what do you find that, you know, most people are kind of like lacking when they, is it just the awareness? Like they're not aware enough to kind of make a decision in their life, or?
I would say it's a combination of factors. The biggest one is the environment.
Yeah.
Most of us were brought up in well-intended families.
Yep, yep.
Who have been brought up by well-intended families, unfortunately not with your best interest into what it really is.
Yeah.
And so there's all sorts of limiting beliefs around money, time, what you're capable of. Just get a job, you know, and one day you retire and get a pension and you'll have a happy life.
Yeah. You know, that does ring true for me too, because when I was younger, limiting beliefs are just natural. I feel like they happen a lot because of what we're taught or things like that. I don't think they're necessarily bad in the beginning because I think it's good, but you get to a point where those limiting beliefs don't help you out anymore. You know, it's like, and one of the things that I learned from my mentor is, and this was back then, so I don't use this anymore, but he said, you know, what would, at the time I was like doing six figures, and he would say, you know, what would U7 do? And U7 is a guy that does seven figures in his agency. How would he react to things? How would he look at life? And, you know, once you start looking at that type of perspective or like just a different perspective, you start eliminating those limiting beliefs because you're no longer that person that believes that type of stuff. So do you also kind of like help people kind of get into a different frame of mindset so that way they can just think more clearly and stuff?
100%.
Yeah.
Because what happens is once you allow limiting beliefs to govern your life, you're stuck.
Yeah.
And then where's your dreams?
Yeah.
How are you feeling on a regular basis? Are you enjoying just getting up and starting your new day and do what you do and be with the people you are? What else can you be doing with your life, right? And I call it the name of the game, life is an adventure.
Yeah, yeah. And that's good because when we asked for photos, like you sent me a bunch of photos that were you on an adventure, you know? How did you come up with that? How did you come up with like that type of title and, you know, that type of lifestyle?
It's a passion. One thing, my last name is Pinzon.
Mm-hmm.
And I say adventurous in my DNA because of the Pinzon brothers that facilitated all the voyages for Columbus's, and they captained the ships as well.
Yeah.
So it was a complete adventure, and it was, I can only imagine in those days, like, what would be the mindset of these people just going into the open seas and just, like, not even knowing where they were going, right?
Yeah.
So I say everything is an adventure, good and not so good.
Right, right.
And it's a matter of how you tap into the lens that you look at what's going on with your life.
Yeah.
So I say, you go from adversity to adventure. And I've had many rough situations. I've lost everything a couple times. I've been on the brush of death. I was almost kidnapped when I was a girl.
Yeah.
So what I discover is with those experiences, as well as with the life-transforming ones, like my mom took us on a trip around the world.
Yeah.
To more than 30 countries.
Oh, wow.
And as a nine-year-old, just seeing the huge diversity in everything.
Yeah.
People, locations, food, music. It was a mind life transforming experience for me.
Yeah.
And since then, I said, you know, it's good to wear those glasses to experience something new. An adventure, the way I define it, is doing something new for the first time.
Yeah.
And it can be as little as going to a different coffee shop, talking to a stranger. It can be taking lessons of something that you're curious about. So do you have a dream you have not done yet, Ulysses?
Me? Oh, man. No. At least not that I can think of right now on the spot, no.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I would say the majority of us, including myself,
yeah,
we all have dreams.
Yeah.
And some of them are covering spider webs, you know, in the bucket. And some people just have the mindset of when my life is perfect, when I have my white picket fence, when I have the money, the blah, 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 then I will go for what I really want.
Yeah.
And that doesn't happen. So.
No, just, that's true.
Yeah. Go for the things that you like, that you enjoy. Be curious. What would you like to learn? Where would you like to go?
Yeah.
Who else can you meet?
And that kind of goes back to, because for me, the way that I kind of live my life is, and it's I don't know if it's dark or not, but like, I'm always aware that I don't have, you know, infinite amount of time to like live. So I'll travel, I'll do that type of stuff, because I understand that like at any moment, you know, anything can just stop, right? Anything can stop. So for me, it's like, yeah, I totally understand that. And because of that, I kind of like live a certain way, you know, but for other people, I think they might not have an awareness. And because of that, they feel like, okay, well, I can always do this later. I can always do this when this happens. How do you help people shift their lens so that way they understand like, no, like you know, you can do it right now?
Yes. So two things in regards to that. And I agree 100% Ulysses with what you were just saying.
Yeah.
Somehow, as human beings, we believe that the other ones are the ones that go to a better place, that they pass away, that, right. You know, and sometimes we feel our mortality is not compromised.
Mm.
We don't know.
Yeah.
If you think just of the amount of life, all of us, we have 24 hours. But really, if you chunk it, remove 8 of sleep, 3 of showering, eating, whatever, so you have a small fraction.
Yeah.
And I invite people to just do this brief exercise. And if you imagine doing a 10 by 10 graph, and imagine you have 100 squares.
Yeah.
And at this point in your life, how many of those squares are gone? And that's assuming 100 years, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Which we don't really have any kind of warranty on.
Yeah, that's true.
So you have a little chunk. But if you really think about the chunk from what I told you, remove one third.
Yeah, yeah.
So really you have a fraction of time left if you were to look at it like that.
No, I have a poster actually. It's called My Life in Weeks. And I have a poster where like every single week, I will exit out, you know, and exit out and exit out. And it's true. Like, I feel like, oh my gosh, like this thing's almost up, you know? I'm like, I feel like I just kind of got started, but you're right. Like a third of it is like already done, you know? And so it is kind of scary to think about it like that, you know? And another thing that I noticed is I saw this tweet a long time ago where basically they were saying that you don't have as much time as you think, because you know how you were saying like, you have a little bit of time for this, a little bit of time for that, da da da. But you also have a little bit of time to see your parents, a little bit of time to see, you know, your brothers. Like, you're not going to see them as often as you might think. You know, it might be only a couple more years, and like, you know, in full and total. So it's like very important to be aware of like how much just life and things like that you actually have. So that way, you know, that way you're living to your best ability, right?
Yes, yes, Ulysses. And to that effect, you know, I have the wonderful blessing of having my mom up in age, over 80, and I got to spend some time with her. And now I have a different relationship where I don't allow any room for any, you know, disagreements, or
yeah.
She is who she is. She was brought up at a different point in time. Yeah, so it's yeah. okay. So if we have an acceptance of everybody else, to we're all living our movie. So right. I say life is like a movie. You get to write it, you get to direct it, yeah. produce it, and star in it. So you are the protagonist of your movie. Yeah. What do you want to make it? I say, make it an adventurous movie where you have fun. Or do you want to make it a soap opera and yeah. drama, and you complain and cry and you sold the, you know, tissues and whatever. It's like, no, you have the choice.
Yeah.
So go for the adventure.
Yeah.
And I say, because part to your question was like, what do I recommend to people? Start with mini adventures. Do something different.
Yeah.
I don't care. Go, if you like coffee, tea, juice, whatever it is, go pay for the person in front of you or behind you and start a conversation. I mean, I just met with a beautiful person who happens to be the makeup artist for Tony Robbins.
Yeah.
And she's doing an amazing project. And I just learned also that coming July 4th, Tony's going to have a new film. I won't go too deep into that. But what I'm saying is, even Tony is getting out of his comfort zone.
Yeah.
You know, he did an undercover operation, which I never thought Tony Robbins would do.
Right.
In my country, Colombia, where I was born and raised, although I'm American hybrid too. But what I'm saying is, everything's possible. And if you just start taking baby steps with mini adventures, bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger things open.
Yeah.
And that's what it's about. Because you want to be playing a bigger game. You want to be enjoying life more. You want to be having more fun. And, you know, here we are right now in the studios, and it's a beautiful location. And I couldn't get transportation here. So I said, I mean, I could have just been like,
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
There's so many things happening around here. So I said, you know what? Yes, I'm wearing a little bit of heels here, but I said, I'm going to walk it.
Oh, wow.
So I walked from, I don't even know how many blocks, because the blocks here are so long.
Yeah.
So, but I would say a couple miles.
Dang, you walked to get here?
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. And when you came here, you were all happy and everything. For me, if I had to walk to get here, I'd be so angry. I'd be like, oh my gosh, you know, I couldn't get an Uber, da da da. No, that's a good way to live, you know? That's a very good way to live. Because, like, that's, you know, sometimes you just can't control certain stuff. But for you, it's like, well, I'm going to make it anyways. And you did it anyways. And in heels? Oh, man, that must have hurt.
Yeah, with a little bit of 90-degree plus temperature outside.
Oh, my God, that's even worse.
So, but it's okay. I mean, I got to see beautiful things that I hadn't seen in a while, because I haven't been in this location in years.
Yeah.
So, but like I said, it's like, it was something unexpected, but I just said, like, and I started talking to people, you know, in the street, like, hey, do you know how to I get to this? Because, like I said, the blocks are so long.
Yeah.
And when the guy told me one block, I kept walking, and I kept asking people, because I'm like, this cannot be a block. I've walked like 10 already.
Yeah, yeah.
So now I understand that their definition of a block here is like my definition of 10 blocks, but it's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Well, the good thing is you made it. The good thing is, I mean, like, yeah, I actually really like that. Like, you know, a lot of times things are not going to go your way, but you have a very good, you know, outlet of life, like how you look at and view things. So I think a lot of people can learn from that. So with that being said, like, how does it look like if somebody does want to work with you?
I have different modalities, like I call it. But one way is I work with people one-on-one, and you're more than welcome to join me. And I do it through a framework called the hero's or shero's journey, which is Joseph Campbell's framework for what you see in Hollywood movies, basically.
Yeah.
So it's about where you're at in your life right now, because we are all ordinary people in one way or another.
Right.
And it's just being aware of that present moment. And then it's about taking a shift in identity.
Yeah.
And you get to adopt your own hero, shero character with the superpowers that are going to allow you to go into the final stage, which is basically you're answering my call to adventure, my CTA,
yeah.
which is basically doing something that you've always dreamed about doing and you haven't done.
Yeah.
That's one way. Then I'm going to be expanding into taking people in blindfolded adventures they don't know anything about.
Yeah.
I would love to take you on one, Ulysses.
I don't know, man. I don't like surprises. But
they're awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
I can tell you, I've done it in the past, and I've done it in many different circumstances. And the beauty when you blindfold people, it's uncomfortable because I've been blindfolded as well.
Yeah.
But there's something about tapping into that fear. It kind of enhances the experience even more.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'd love to surprise you with that one day. So blindfolded adventures is going to be another portion. And then I've seen the biggest transformations happen when you immerse people in fully experiential adventures.
Yeah.
Meaning I want to take groups of people for 1 week experiences like that to exotic locations.
Yeah.
I would love to surprise them with that. But no, for that one, I think I have to tell people up front.
I
just love trying new things, meeting new people. And it's like you just don't know. I say fear steals your dreams.
Yeah.
And if you're allowed to be in that space where you're fearful, you're not allowing life to flow.
Yeah.
So just start getting out of the comfort zone with mini adventures. Grow it to bigger and bigger and bigger adventures. I love to work with people and help them transition in that realm. And I love to celebrate with people getting into that big celebration, big smile. They finally realized a dream of theirs.
Yeah, that's beautiful. So if somebody's listening to this and they're like, okay, I need that. Like my life is, you know, just not as adventurous like I'd like it to be. Where can people find you if they want to work with you?
So Yvette Pinzon. And if you look at my social media, I'm available online. And yes, feel free to reach out to me. I offer people always the opportunity, whether they have questions, they can reach out to me. If they have, if they're not sure, if they want more information, I always offer discovery sessions for people where we can talk about where they are. And if it's workable to work together and what's the best way I recommend, then, you know, let people know.
Perfect. Well, I appreciate you being on the show. Thank you so much.
Oh, Ulysses, thank you so much. It's always a pleasure. And I tell you this, you are super inspiring and I appreciate you so much. And thank you. Thank you for having me here.
No problem.
And thank you all for being here.